I was born in the summer of 1977 in Los Angeles, California. My father, John Kinney, received the news of my birth 2 days later when a telegram reached him on the Greek island of Mykonos, where he was directing a film. He said it had just started raining, and the telegram arrived sopping wet and written in Greek. The film's camera operator translated. Congratulations! She's 6 pounds, 12 ounces, and her name is Alice. I'm told so much champagne popped that night, it sounded like fireworks. My father made personal films that captured the spirit of his generation. He found the truth in the bedroom, the agony in love, and the humor in it all. In my father's obituary, the New York Times called him a comic poet, a sentiment I assure you no one would have loved more than him. My dad's work brought him great joy, respect, and success. And with that success, he bought this car and this house, where I lived every other weekend of my childhood. My dad's personal life was a little less of a success. He married several women and lived with several more. But he was the first to admit the end of his affairs was always entirely his fault. This was certainly the case with his last wife, my beautiful mother, Lillian. My mother was 22 years old when she met my dad, which made her 26 years his junior. Theirs was a real hold on to your hat kind of love. A love that would never last. My parents divorced soon after my fourth birthday. Unfortunately for my mother, this inspired some of my dad's best work. But he said it was me who completed his third act. My dad wasn't very sentimental, but he always loved my birthday. Every year he'd say the same thing. This is your day, your year. Get ready, Alice. The future is yours.
Mom, are you in there?
Yeah, just a sec.
Mom, remember the drought.
Oh, yeah.
Mom, open up. Open the door.
I'm coming.
Happy birthday.
Oh, my gosh, you guys. Come here.
Mom, is everything okay?
Yeah, I'm great. It's my birthday, and I love you both so much. Okay, who wants pancakes?
I do.
So, girls, how are we feeling? First day, new school, are you nervous? Are you excited?
Excited, definitely.
Nervous, extremely. Wait, can kids have heart attacks?
Oh my gosh, honey, no. But I understand, this is a big deal. Do you want to listen to your favorite song? Or maybe we could go over your schedule and talk about what's making you anxious.
I don't want to do that doctor's stupid exercises. Can't I just go on antidepressants like every other kid?
Oh my God, Isabel, for the billionth time, you are not depressed. I'm positive.
Please, Mom, you know, I'm feeling exhausted, hopeless, anxious, and I don't enjoy the things that I once loved.
Music, please.
I'm not alone, you know. Depression affects over 20 million Americans, and I'm an American, so...
Where are you getting this from?
The Zoloft commercial, obviously.
Okay, Iz, you're being a little bit dramatic. You're just going to walk right into first period.
Oh, no!
What did you forget?
My summer reading book report.
Oh, God.
Okay. It's no big deal. I'm going to drop you guys off at school, and then I'm going to go back to the house, and I'll bring it back to you, okay, honey? But please try and be a little bit more responsive.
I'm working on it.
Okay.
It's okay. You can just email it to me, and I can print it out in the library.
See?
Well, assuming I have time, and they let me.
Okay, this is it. Wow. This is going to be great. Look at this. It is so much prettier than your school in New York. It has trees and sunshine. Look at that cool mural. Okay, you want me to walk you in?
No.
Got it. Unanimous. All right, don't forget that after school, we're going to have a little birthday celebration with ice cream. And then tonight, you guys are sleeping over at Nana's house, okay?
Can you tell Nana I go to bed at 9 now?
I think it's 8:45, Missy. But yes, I will tell her.
Love you.
Love you, honey. Have a good day.
Bye.
Hi, welcome.
Hi. Isabella? You got this. You've got a great first day outfit. You're hilarious. You're brilliant. You're cool. You're a city kid.
Mom.
You're going to be great. I promise.
I guess. But right now, I just want to go home.
Okay, you're going to be home before you know it.
I meant to New York. Happy birthday, Mom.
Thanks, sweetie. Have fun!
didn't say what happened.
He's a maniac. Indians never. Teddy, you packed? Oh, sorry. I thought you said you had a plan.
You are looking at it.
George, enough. We need to focus on our meeting. Now, let's go over the pitch. Teddy, should we run some lines? I think it could be good to act out some bits in the room.
I'll play Sam, you play Jane.
But I'm playing Sam in the movie.
Fine. I'll play Jane.
All right, let's just make sure we stick to our guns, okay? I've heard horror stories about great scripts getting totally dismantled by these kinds of people.
Aren't these the kind of people who are going to actually help us get our movie made?
I've read about it. It happens. Also, let's agree not to get talked out of shooting the movie in black and white. Right?
I get it. I don't need the extra weird stare. Guys, we're going to do great. I have a really good feeling about this.
Everybody ready to rumble?
Yeah, wait. Where are we going to stay?
Do I look worried?
Alice Kinney is the principal owner and designer of Alice Kinney Designs. Alice is a depressed, newly separated loser. Hello?
There she is, the California girl.
Hey.
How's your birthday going?
It's good. So far, there's a lot going on. It's the girl's first day of school. You called them, right?
Hey, I do not need you to remind me to do that.
Okay. So you did or you didn't?
They will hear from me before the end of the day. Anyway, look, I was calling you to wish you a very happy 40th. It's fine, right? It's not as bad as you thought.
It's going great so far. I'm very busy. I'm just prepping for that job interview tomorrow.
Oh, right. Yeah. Yeah. Good luck with that.
Thanks. Listen, Austin, have you heard anything about the move here? Because the girls ask me every single day, is Daddy coming? When's he getting his house? I'm kind of running out of answers.
Yeah, I ask all the time, too. They think they might have found someone to run things out there, so that's good.
And once that happens, then it should all fall into place.
Austin, they're ready for you.
Okay, I'll be there in one sec. Alice?
Yeah?
Don't get mad at me for saying this, but I miss you.
Boys, you made it!
Yes!
Hey, you told us we were serious about this. It was LA or bust, so here we are.
Listen, so sorry I had to keep pushing this meeting. You know, it's the end of the summer, the Jewish holiday. This time of year is just insane.
No worries at all.
All right, good stuff. So, here we go. Okay, Harry Dorsey, Teddy Dorsey, George Appleton, director, writer, star of Mad Youth, the best short. You know what? No, the best film I saw at South by.
Oh, thank you.
I've been able to stop talking about you guys since the festival. I'm Jason.
Great to meet you. I'm Jason, too.
Double Jasons. Mind blowing. Yeah, I know. It's crazy. All right, let's have a seat, everybody. Now, listen up. We have some great ideas about how to turn your short into a feature. And again, I really did love it. You know, I saw it again this morning while I was running on the treadmill. It is special.
This is going to be a breakout role for you, Teddy. We should get you out on auditions right away, don't you think?
Yeah. Definitely. And George, your writing. Your writing is so spot on. I just love that Joan character. I think we've all had a Joan in our lives. Am I right?
Thanks. It's Jane.
Would you ever be interested in any episodic work?
I mean, yeah.
But in terms of our movie, what's the next move here?
Right. Okay. So, well, first thing we need to do is to attach a producer, and it just so happens somebody's already interested. I might have slipped your short to Justin Miller, and he kind of flipped for it.
Justin Miller?
Oh, is that the guy who produced all those horror movies? He's been looking to do something a little more human. He's very smart, by the way, and he's done insanely well off those horror films. Okay, guys. He's a big producer. He likes your movie. This is a good thing.
Definitely. But does he know we don't have a finished script yet?
Yeah, and that is a great thing, actually, because Justin wants to develop it with you guys. And this one here looks like he wants to kill me.
No.
I said George.
Only thing is, I talked to his development guy, and they're concerned about the movie being in black and white.
That's okay.
We can, maybe we can talk him into it.
Right. Okay, guys, look. If you don't like him, we're going to find somebody else. But Justin can make your movie happen, so be open, okay?
Yeah, we're open.
Thank you so much.
Are you Teddy Dorsey from Mad Youth?
I'm just trying to be a normal human being.
Oh, my God. One day, you've got to come in and,
Here, can we chat for 30 seconds about the black and white
George,
thing? Just let me get it off my chest.
Faith, please.
Guys, hey, I want to make a toast. Seriously. To this incredible journey and to us. And hey, how's it going?
Hi.
That was a beautiful toast. Very moving.
I love L.A.
Oops. Sorry.
No problem.
I guess I've got a shot glass.
Okay, you stay.
I
do you like
this.
It?
Yes, it is your best business card yet.
Oh, thanks. But be honest with me, am I one of those women who thinks every one of their hobbies is worthy of being a profession?
What? No.
Maybe you're just good at too many things. I love you, but I was a terrible clothing designer and even worse photographer.
Well,
but come on, that's what you've always...
Thank you.
girls in a new school, and I... Look, I'm starting a business, and...
Right. Okay.
I need to get settled and... Girls, it's my birthday. Let's have fun.
Okay. So, where on the East Coast are you from?
New York.
No way.
Yes.
I'm from New York. Yeah. Where in New York are you from?
The Upper East Side. How about you?
Well, not New York.
Hello. Excuse me. Pardon me.
Can I help you?
Can I have 2 glasses of rosé, please?
Yes.
Thank you. Hi.
How you doing tonight?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm doing great. Thank you for asking.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like to offer to buy your drinks, but...
Really?
I think the bartender is slightly under the impression that I'm taking her home tonight.
Oh, but you're not.
No, I'm not.
And why is that?
Because I have to stop talking to you.
I hate to do this, but the manager is making me ask for your ID, so...
So, I'll give it to you. Okay. How's that?
You should take it as a compliment.
I'm Harry, by the way. I'm definitely old enough to drink alcohol.
I'm Alice. Me too. Obviously.
I ran after you like a fool would do. But mama didn't raise no fools and I should know. That baby you got me. That's all I can say for you. You've got so too much so much to go. You're supposed to groove and say there's nothing fake about you. Baby, you got it. People can be cruel. Just say I lost my cool. But it's very hard to keep my cool when I'm around.
How does everybody feel about dancing?
Yes!
Yes, everything's great.
you feeling?
Better.
Good, good.
Oh, Alice, I'm so sorry you had to see me like that. Yeah, it's not exactly a stellar first impression.
Please, I used to throw up all the time when I was your age.
Oh.
I mean, not all the time, but, you know, I get it.
Yeah, my embarrassment level is still a 10. Sorry.
Oh, yeah.
I had clothes on when I got here, right?
Yeah, I don't know where... I don't know when they... Mm-hmm. But here they are.
Thanks. I guess George and Teddy left me here. They must have thought we,
No. They're in the living room. I guess they passed out, too.
Oh.
Because we all raged last night.
Yeah. Did you watch these?
I did, but only because I was doing a load, and I've been up since 5:30.
Thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, well, I'll get out of your hair, then.
Great.
Okay.
Not that you do not have to feel bad about any of this. I never get out, like, ever. So this was actually really good for me, and I had a really fun time. And thanks to you, I didn't do anything I regret, so... And I just always act out on my birthday. It's like my own personal New Year's Eve, so I just go like, what? And I just reel it back to normal.
Well, look, hey, I'm happy to let some steam out of the kettle. I'm, gonna stand up now.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Yes. Okay, of course.
Okay. Can't believe you're making us late on our first week of school.
I said sorry.
Hurry up, you guys. Rosebud, grab the backpack.
Can you go fix Rosie a bagel?
Sure, come on.
Thanks. You could have called first.
Well, who would have thought you'd have company at 7 in the morning?
So, we're just gonna slip out. Thank you very much for everything, Mrs. Oh, my God. You look so familiar. Have we met before?
That's insane.
No, I feel like I definitely know you from somewhere.
She was married to John Kenney. She was in all of his movies.
Who's this one now? Oh, my God. Wait, you're Lillian Stewart? That's awesome. Really?
And I'm pretty sure this is John Kinney's house.
Hold on, how do you know all of this?
I stumbled into that room back there with all your dad's stuff. I'm sorry, I just got a little lost. I'm a huge, huge fan of your father's.
You're John Kinney's daughter?
Yeah, she is. And you are?
Yeah.
Am I free to head home now? Because
not yet.
No.
Okay. As fun as this has been, believe it or not, I have a meeting to go to, so maybe we should wrap it up.
We're filmmakers, too. You know, just like your husband.
Everybody is, doll. We're in L.A.
I can't believe you're here, and you're you. This is surreal. You're a terrific actress.
Come on. I mean, I did a few small parts here and there.
You were also smoking hot, like in the movie of the yellow bikini. I was like, whoa, hello.
Come on. Alice, did you hear what he said?
Yes.
John sits down at the table next to mine at Ma Maison, and 10 minutes later, he pulls his chair up to mine and offers me the lead in Lola. Said he liked the way I ordered my cute Lorraine. I know.
So, I have to get going. Does everybody want to walk out with me?
Actually, I'm going to stay and make the boys some breakfast, so can you drive the kids to school? This is so fun.
Is that cool for hanging with your mom? For a little?
Yeah, no. That's fine with me.
Wait, so you're saying that was your first movie ever? Hey, Alice?
Yeah?
Do you have a minute?
Sure.
Could we just maybe exchange phone numbers or...
Oh, Harry, I'm very late. Listen, I think you woke up to a completely different person than you met last night. And I appreciate the gesture. I really do. But how old are you? Like, 30? 29?
Something like that.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, girls, come on. Time to get in the car.
Okay. She's so intense.
No, I'm not. Good luck with everything. Maybe I'll see you around.
Hope so.
Come on, ladies.
You guys have a sleepover?
What?
How did you meet?
Yeah, are you friends with their mom?
Friends with their mom? How old do I look?
I don't know. Mom age?
Wow, you have done just a tremendous amount of work, Alice.
Oh, yeah.
This is just a lot of blue.
Well, I Googled your house, and yeah. I thought the Hamptons thing would be great.
Yeah. Why don't you sit down for a second?
Yeah, I
feel like I might have misled you in some way, because the truth is, I don't...
Does that sound okay with you?
Oh, yeah, of course. Absolutely. I'm up for anything.
Okay, because there is one room that I would need you to start right away.
That would be amazing. Yeah. What room?
It's my daughter Gwyneth's playroom.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Do you want to show me the room?
I can't do that right now because I have to take this call. I'm so sorry about that, and I have a blowout. But why don't you email me,
Okay, so the meeting's over.
And then we'll sort of organize everything.
Okay. Should I
Marta,
follow?
Can
okay.
you please show Alice to G's room? Marta!
By the way, can you just make sure to take your shoes off when you get into the house? We have kind of a strict policy.
Hello, Rob, I hear you. Jesus.
You'll need to
yell.
So she taught you about the solar system?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, can you name any of the planets?
I can name Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. Pluto isn't considered a proper planet.
All right. Here you go. Oh, sorry. What? Just hear me out. They need a place to crash. You've got a guest house. So I thought, you know, maybe they could stay here.
Stay here? I don't even know two of their names, Mom.
Oh, come on. Since when is having three adorable guys hanging around such a bad thing? Maybe they could help you out a little.
Help me out? Help me out with what? Did they ask you to ask me this?
No.
Tell the truth.
Absolutely not. It was entirely my idea. I think these boys have a real shot at making it. I adored their movie. It was raw and great.
You saw their movie?
Yeah. Look, they're dead broke. If you don't let them stay here, then they have to move home back to upstate New York or wherever and blow their chance at having a career here. They need you, Alice. How's that? They don't know anyone here. I like them. Your father would have liked them. Be a patron of the arts, Alice. It's good for the soul.
Why are you suddenly romanticizing Dad? The man impregnated another woman while he was still married to you.
Why do you always obsess over that?
Why don't you obsess over that?
Because I'm a big girl and he's gone now, so I won.
Well, if they hadn't met me, was there a plan B?
Maybe it was fate that they met you. Maybe you could be the person who says they were living at my house when they wrote whatever it's called. Look, just for a month or so.
A month?
Okay, a week, whatever. If it doesn't work out, sayonara. But just try looking at this as something that could be sort of exciting.
What if the kids don't feel comfortable? I mean, you know everything that Isabella's going through. This could really set her off.
So incredibly cool of you. Thank you so much.
Seriously? You're a lifesaver.
Can I help you with anything?
No, I've got it. Okay, the couch turns into a bed. The hot water over here takes a minute to turn on, and there's extra towels in the closet.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Oh.
I'm just gonna grab that and flush down the toilet.
Okay, guys, I hope last night didn't confuse you. This is definitely not an after-party and crash-on-the-couch type of place. This is more of a market lists on the fridge, Latin homework after school, dinner at 6 kind of house. And I know that's not the coolest stomping grounds for a bunch of starving artists like yourselves, but let's just do our best not to cramp each other's style, okay?
Well said. Can I talk to you outside for a sec?
Alice, I think you and I should just start over. Yeah, obviously we had no idea we'd be living together.
We're not.
I mean that I'd be staying here. And, well, clearly I did not rock your world last night. So maybe we should just pretend that whole thing never happened and start over as friends.
I agree. And I'm actually glad you brought it up.
Good. And I'm only saying something because we're staying here and the kids and everything.
Harry, we're good. We're friends.
We're attracted to each other on just my end, not on yours. My bad.
Telling her they should just be friends.
How do you know that?
I speak Harry.
Do you think he'll stick to it?
Depends how long we're here. She seems uneasy. You think she's okay with this?
No, I think she's super cool with it. And this place is gorgeous and, like, weirdly clean and 600 times nicer than the hotel!
Okay, let's just stay a couple days until the Justin Miller meeting.
Oh my God, I'm not kidding. You gotta feel these sheets.
Oh, wow. These sheets are insane. What are they made of? This is pretty great.
love to see his handwriting.
I literally have goosebumps. Why is this all in boxes? Shouldn't this be at the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences?
Yeah, I just moved back, and I'm having a hard time letting go of some of these things.
Why did you move back? If you don't mind me asking.
No, that's a very normal question, and one I should probably come up with an answer for. You know, my husband and I are separated. He's in the music business, and there's just a lot of partying, which was really fun, and we had a great time. And then we got older, and we weren't kids anymore. And then we had kids, and he was still coming in at 2 o'clock in the morning, smelling like Don Julio. And I tried to hold it together. I really, really did, so hard. It was. But, you know, God, you make a decision about your life when you're 25 years old, and then you fast forward 15 years later, and you think, God, is that really the life decision that's, like, a good life decision for the rest of your life? And then you're just like, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. You know?
I'm sorry about your marriage, but you seem to be handling everything really well.
Client wants me to come over, but I told her I can't come. Isabel has guitar lessons on Thursdays, and she wants me to pick her up a pressed juice on the way. That's weird, right?
Yeah, I think that would be considered weird. I could take Isabel to class if you want. I mean, I don't have a car, but I'd be happy to help.
Really? Yeah. Thank you. My dad's old car is in the garage. You know how to drive a stick, right?
Wasn't so bad. I want to be a writer, and my homeroom teacher, Miss Avery, told me about this playwriting contest. Teachers pick about 5 plays to be performed at the fall show. Miss Avery thinks I should submit something, but I'm really not sure.
That's so cool. You should definitely do it.
Well, truthfully, I would love to, but we have to perform our own plays, and I don't think my body would physically allow for that.
Won't you regret it if you don't do it? It sounds like a great opportunity.
Yeah, but I get sort of anxious, you know? Just sometimes. It's on and off, and the cause is unknown, but it may be related to an imbalance of natural chemicals between the nerve cells and the brain. Says WebMD.
Sorry, I should take this. We'll get back to this. Hello?
George, Jason Green from WCA, how you doing?
Hi, I'm great, thanks. What's up?
I have good news.
There's this thriller I think we told you about in our meeting. They're looking for someone to do a new pass on the script. I sent over your writing samples, and they love them.
Loved. Can I set up a meeting?
Wow, I'm flattered. That's, they use the word love?
Really?
No, but you can just tell.
Oh, is that the other Jason?
Hi, yes, I just jumped on.
Oh, hi, yeah, can I discuss with the guys and then, let you know?
George, it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world for you to put your name out there on your own and make some money.
We got a job. I'll set it up, okay? Well, this is good, I promise.
Well, let me think about it. Hello? Jason? Other Jason?
That sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, it does, right? I don't know, I don't know if I'm ready to go out on my own.
Won't you regret it if you don't do it? Sounds like a great opportunity.
I like what you did there. How's Ken?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're going to redo the whole playroom. You want it a little more age-appropriate. You want to keep bright colors but tone down the pink. A teepee would be cool. Maybe some beanbag chairs.
Hey, hi, girl. Sorry to interrupt. Oh, hey, Dexter. Hi, honey. Alice, can I borrow you for a second?
Sure. So I was supposed to be at this event like 15 minutes ago, and then my nanny calls me and tells me she's in brutal traffic. She's not going to be here for another hour. So, look, I wouldn't normally do this, but could you please stay until she gets here?
Well, I mean, it's 5:15,
no,
and I can't.
I know. I mean, obviously, I would pay you for your time. I just don't know what else to do.
Well,
you
wouldn't have to pay.
You're so sweet. Thank you so much.
Wait,
Alice is going to babysit for you until Idalia gets here, okay, honey? I love you. And could you just give her a bath, just a quick one, and then let Dexter out before you go, okay? Thank you.
When were you going to tell me that 3 strangers were living in your house?
I'm sorry. I know. That I should have.
I mean, are you Airbnb in the house?
What? No, of course not.
So where did you meet them then?
I met them at a... You know what? Look, it's really not that big of a deal. They're just going to stay in the guest house for a few days. It was actually my mother's idea.
Now, Isabel told me that one of them drove her to a guitar class. I don't want your house guests hanging out with the girls, okay? I feel weird enough about not being there.
Well, then why don't you come...
Isabel. I think someone needs a mark.
Thank you. Now please unlearn that.
Hey guys, dinner's ready. Let's do this.
Should we take the plates outside?
What's outside?
You'll see.
Come on. Where are we going?
I can't tell you.
Tonight, Harry.
Oh, are you kidding? I should be thanking you.
No, seriously. My kids haven't seen that many of my dad's movies, so it was really special.
Well, they are so cool. By the way, job well done.
Thanks. Really taking to you guys. I think they're happy to have some male energy around here.
It is very pink in this house. You seem to have aced the single parent thing, though. Really aced it. I mean, yeah, I assume it's not as easy as it looks. Well, you have and I've got this thing about you, and it's super impressive. And personally, I think it's pretty brave what you did starting over. I don't know your ex, but he must be some kind of maniac to have let you slip through his hands. Where does this go?
It goes over there.
You know this cabinet is broken, right? You gotta stop blushing. Your face is too cute when you blush, I can't handle it. You got a screwdriver?
Thanks. That cabinet has been broken for so long, you have no idea.
Anything else I can do for you? Got anything from IKEA I can assemble? Or...
Guys, thank you so much for coming out on Saturday. I appreciate that. I'm heading off to Shanghai tomorrow, so I'm glad we could get this going.
Can I get you guys anything else?
No, thanks, Maya. This looks fantastic.
Okay, great.
Thanks.
Enjoy.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So, I'm not going to pull any punches here. I get it. I'm the horror guy. It's all basically anybody ever sends me. So, when WCA sent me your short, and nobody died in it or turned into a zombie or something, I thought, all right, well, this is fantastic.
Thank you so much. We're so glad you liked it.
But if I'm going to go out of my wheelhouse, there are basically three kinds of movies that I'm interested in producing. Okay, female-centric comedies.
Oh, George writes women really well. My love interest is a great part.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't exactly say it's a female-centric comedy, but...
I totally agree. Okay, forget women. Here's something else that might work for you guys. What about a found footage love story? You know, I mean, like, no one's ever done that before.
You mean, like, somebody found footage of Sam and Jane's love story? I mean, why would they have been...
Filming themselves.
Filming, yeah, right. Exactly.
I have no idea. You know, just a thought. All right, the last thing I'm into... an awards movie. You know, like a really... a good movie. You know what I mean? Like they used to make.
We would love to make a really good movie.
Yes.
Yeah? some quick thoughts here. You okay?
He had some interesting things to say, George.
Right? Like he wants to help us get our movie made. That was incredibly interesting.
He was a parody of a movie
producer. I mean, he did say some crazy shit.
What is wrong with you both?
He's a big deal and he believes in us.
And actually makes me like us less. Look, let's just continue the conversation, okay? It was a first meeting. George? Hey, did you look at me? George? We're on the same team, okay?
All right, we can keep talking to him, but we're not setting it in the South, where none of us have ever been, by the way.
Fine, I agree. That's not a thing.
What are you doing?
I've never been in the Pacific.
Okay, you're just gonna...
I'm going in.
You know these things take forever to happen, right? I'm just gonna keep writing it the way we always wanted it to be. Between us, kind of took another little job in the meantime. I'm just doing it in my spare time.
Seriously?
Yeah. Something came my way from WCA.
No kidding. What's the job?
Don't tell Harry.
I won't. What is it?
Because if he found out, he'd just make it about him.
Just tell me what it is already.
It's a rewrite of a thriller. Anyway, it pays well, and it's good to have a backup plan, you know? What if being three boy wonders doesn't work out? Harry has this vision of the three of us lined up in tan suits at Cannes. Meanwhile, for once, I'd actually like to be able to make some money.
Well, just warn me before you tell him so I can leave the country.
You know, at some point, you're going to need to learn to be less of a little brother.
I don't have the same shit with him that you do, George.
I guess you support him sleeping with Alice, then.
Can I not be the odd man out because I'm the only one not pining for Alice?
Okay, come on. We're not going there. All I'm saying is iceberg ahead. Because when he changes his mind about her, or she gets tired of his shit... Look, all I'm saying is we just need to start looking for another place to live. Which I'll be able to pay for now because of my job.
I don't want to leave Alice's. I like being with their family.
Yeah, well, we're going to have to leave eventually.
Well, eventually today, my bro.
Hold on. I don't think we should interrupt.
Yeah. Okay.
Namaste. I'm Teddy.
So tell me about the other two guys. What are they like?
Okay. Well, Teddy used to work at the Genius Bar, so he's been helping me with my website, which is awesome. He's adorable. And George has really taken to Isabel. He encouraged her to submit a play to a school contest, which has been amazing for her.
Yeah, hold on a minute. So I think you're telling me that you have free live-in childcare, full-time tech support, and sex.
I can't complain. That feels like a lot.
Why is it a lot? It's like the perfect chance to show off your new boyfriend.
He's not my boyfriend.
What is he then?
No, he's young, and I might feel too self-conscious.
Well, all the single guys we know date women that age. They're not self-conscious.
That's true.
Come on, bring him.
Okay, maybe. Maybe. This is just gonna take a second. Why are the gates open? Is Zoe here?
She'll be back soon. Can I help you?
I just have these pillows for the playroom.
Oh, okay.
ridiculous work for nothing. I mean, I organized this woman's jeans, Teddy.
Well, what are you taking?
It's for anxiety. You know, I just take a half of a half, an hour during a day.
That's a large half.
I should have quit before it came to this.
Alice, everything you told me about this woman sounds awful, but you gotta check yourself. Everything's gonna be okay.
Promise?
I do. I mean, look at us. How did we end up here with you? I think things do actually work out for a reason. And look, just forget about Zoe. This just means it's time for you to move on. It's gonna be easy now because your website is live, what? Your Pinterest is up, and it's all linked to your Facebook and Instagram.
My website is live.
Oh, yeah. Check it out, buddy.
Oh, my God. Teddy, this is amazing. Thank you.
That was Justin.
Yeah?
He thinks he might have found someone to finance our movie.
No way!
Yeah.
That's amazing!
You know, we're gonna get drinks tomorrow to talk about it.
Wow. Oh, wait, so does that mean you're busy tomorrow night?
Yeah, but just for a little. Did you have something in mind?
I mean, I did, actually. Tracy's having this little dinner thing, and if you were up for it, I thought maybe you would come with me?
I'd love to do that.
Really?
I've been wanting to do something with you outside the house. I mean, I love what we've been doing inside the house, but yes, let's be on a date.
Okay.
I'll have to meet you after the drinks.
Sure, no problem.
What should I wear? It's not, like, dressy, is it?
And I feel like I'm clinging to a cloud.
No, I'm going to have one more. I got to go. I have to quit.
I get misty just holding your hand. Might be the sound of your hello, that music I hear.
I get misty,
the moment you're near. You can say that you're leading me on, but it's just what I want.
Come in. Alice, I am so sorry about last night. The drinks, they went late, and Justin, he invited all these people, and the guy wouldn't shut up. And I'm pretty sure he's getting us the money, so I couldn't ditch him. I think that is straight.
Oh, you couldn't ditch him, but you could ditch me.
No, I didn't know what else to do. I got caught up, and...
You know what the truth is? I don't care what happened. I just know how it made me feel, and I don't want to feel like that.
Okay, well, please don't let one stupid night get in the way of what's happening here.
What is happening here?
I don't think either of us know the answer to that.
Okay, because you came to me and you said we shouldn't get involved, and then you showed up and you fixed my cabinet door, and then you kissed me, and whatever, I allowed that to happen. But at some point, I have to start knowing better. And that point is now. You're a 27-year-old kid, Harry. And it's exciting, and you're fantastic, and you're on the cusp of being a really great guy. But 27-year-olds just screw up. They just do. I know, because I used to be one. But the last thing that I need right now is to be sitting at some party in a dress, waiting for someone or something that isn't going to show up for me. So whatever this is or was, it's just got to end. Okay?
knew it.
I didn't.
This is major. Congrats.
Can I ask you a beyond huge enormous favor? Oh, and you can say no. Oh, sorry. Am I interrupting you working? Oh, is it the job?
Yeah, but who cares? What's up? You can ask me anything.
Will you go up on stage with me? At the play?
On stage?
No, not like in the play or anything. Just off to the side. You can see the whole thing from there. I asked Miss Avery and she said it was fine. I told her it's like having an emotional support dog, only human. Anyways, just in case I feel nervous or like I'm going to pass out or anything, just seeing you there with me.
Hey, Iz, it would be a great honor. I'll be there.
Yeah, so they never found my brother, so naturally I don't do boats. But I gotta let that go.
What do you do? Because Corey wasn't exactly sure.
I used to work for a developer. Basically, we would just tear down things you love and put up things you hate.
Are you gonna drink that?
No, you can have it. Yeah, so, oh, Alice, have you seen that TED Talk by any chance on the science of happiness?
Mm-mm.
I think you'd really like it.
Is it that obvious?
No, that's not what I'm saying. It's just, it just really touched me. And about 8 months ago, I quit my job.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, just like that. I had a Jerry Maguire moment.
Oh, my God, I love Jerry Maguire.
Yeah, I moved to Bali and lived there for a few months until I actually came down with malaria and I had to come back here and then I'm trying to get my old job back. Anyway, I think it was Thomas Brown, Sir Thomas Brown, who said, I am the richest man alive. I have that in me.
Oh, my God. Turn.
I'm okay.
My arch nemesis is here.
Why do you have an arch nemesis?
She's standing next to the Sarah Palantel girl. She looks all rich and depressed. I'm gonna go talk to her, Nate.
Oh, Alice, I don't think you should.
I think I'm gonna do it.
Alice, don't do that.
Here I go.
Alice. Okay.
Hi, Alice. My gosh.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I'm on a date. With a man.
Great. I don't think you've met my husband, Rob. This is Alice. She's okay. Been sort of helping out around the house.
Nice to meet you, Rob. I'm your wife's bitch.
I don't know if I would call it that.
Really? Would you say you're a nice person to me, or would you say you're nicer to maybe the labradoodle?
It's a labradoodle.
Whatever.
Okay. Boom. What are you doing with your face? Are you unwell?
I think it's Dexter.
Okay, that is not nice, Alice. He's a rescue, and I find that really offensive. I think that you've had a little bit too much to drink. And that you're sort of embarrassing yourself.
I'm embarrassing myself?
Yes.
Well, that's refreshing, because normally that's your department.
Okay.
Am I right, Bob?
Alice, let's just call this quits, and I will call you in the morning.
Hey, babe, I quits, okay? Because you cheated on me with the fancy, stylish woman. And on top of that, you're a deeply dark individual, so we done.
Great. We done.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
So, want to tell me what happened?
Well, I drank my date under the table, and I was so rude. And then I saw Zoe Bell and her kimono and her cute husband, and I went temporarily insane.
Jesus. I hope you quit, at least.
Oh, yes. That I made very clear.
Well, dare I ask why you're feeling so pugnacious this evening?
All signs point to the lead singer of your band.
I was afraid of that. You know, he tends to have this effect on people. Thing you gotta realize about Harry, and I say this out of love, is he doesn't do the right thing enough. Doesn't know how. Trust me.
Do you know what the difference is between men and women? Men they can just do things. And women have to think about the consequences and the feelings and the pros and cons. And we make lists. And men just act. They just do. Not you, though, George. You're one of the good ones.
Thank you, Alice.
You're like a woman.
Thank you.
George Appleton.
Hi.
Big fan of your family.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna let you two, because I gotta... Just gonna...
Yeah, okay. Oh, it feels so good to be here.
You did such an incredible job with the house. It totally feels like you know.
Thanks.
I'm really impressed. God, you remember us sitting in here when you brought me to meet your dad?
Yeah, a million years ago.
And you look different, too.
I do?
Yeah, relaxed or something. You look fantastic, huh?
Well, your couch and mirror aren't really stellar roles, right? I've had quite
the... You know I had to come here, right? You get that. I mean, there are three strange guys living with my family. And you stop calling me back all of a sudden. You know, girls are not FaceTiming me anymore. Where'd you keep your forks?
In the drawer. So you just showed up unannounced? Don't you think you should have called first and then told me that you were coming so I could at least prepare, told the girls? Well, or is this just what worked for you, Austin?
I would have called, but I was afraid you were going to tell me that I couldn't come.
I always tell you to come.
You know, when you left, I finally felt like I wasn't letting anyone down anymore. And that was good for a minute. But then I realized that the best part of my life had just moved away across the country. And there I was, alone in our old place. There's no more laughter. No more meals together. No more monkeys jumping on the bed. And I miss our family. So I bought a ticket to LA and I left within the hour because I wanted to say this to your face. To your beautiful face. Let's fix this. Let's not give up.
What's he doing just showing up here out of nowhere?
I think we should go in there. I think she needs us.
Oh, really? What are you going to do? Are you going to go in there? Are you going to say, I'm the captain now? Huh? Look, they're sitting so close together.
Guys, enough, okay? He's the father of her children.
Okay, but she's moved on. She doesn't need him anymore.
George, is he good looking? I can't tell from here.
Yeah, what's his vibes? Losery? I don't know. He's got like a classic Clark Gable thing. It's like a little bit of Sean Penn in there, like he could jump you at any moment, you know what I mean?
Clark Gable meets Sean Penn. I'm going inside.
Harry, come on, man. The last thing she needs.
How do you know what she needs? Oh my God. She's taking him to the guest room. He's staying.
Well, thank you for putting me up.
I'm a little bit drunk. I'll probably regret it in the morning. Not that drunk. Good night, Austin.
I meant what I said, Al. Will you just think about it? Please take a seat.
Larry.
Austin.
Why is he staying with us?
Teddy, I can't. What am I supposed to do? Ask him to stay in a hotel?
Okay, why is this guy in LA?
I can think of three really good reasons.
It seems pretty selfish to just show up like this.
We'll meet Austin.
Alice, please stop avoiding me. Hey, can we just, I don't know, talk?
Whoa!
Girls!
Guess
what?
Good morning!
Oh,
I'm so happy to see you.
Oh, Rosie! You're so tall! Look at you, like a supermodel.
Is looking. Oh my goodness, loving those sneakers.
When did you get here?
He came in late last night. We thought we'd surprise you this morning.
Good to see you, Lil.
Yeah.
Mwah. Looking fetching as usual.
Me, you are nuts. Look, I have to change for my spinning class, so I'm going to get going. Allie, I'll talk to you later, okay?
Yep.
Still cute.
Okay, let's eat.
We were walking back from dinner on this beautiful moonlit night through this tiny little village just outside Saint-Rémy-de-Provence. And we took one wrong turn.
Oh.
And suddenly, out of nowhere.
Oh my God, I forgot about this.
This strange little woman appeared. She pushes me in the chair. She grabbed your mother's bag, and your mother, just immediately, without a second thought, sprinted.
guys are filmmakers?
Yeah, heard that. God, I have no idea how you guys do it. It takes such discipline. And I guess, I mean, at the end of the day, it's totally down to luck, isn't it, if it turns into anything, right?
Yeah, luck and talent.
Copy that. A lot of luck. Hey, I had an idea. Why don't we go for dinner tonight?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Sunday night dinner, like we used to. That'd be fun, right? You could show me your new favorite place.
Yeah, can we, Mommy, please?
Yeah, we could go early. Be back by 8.
Please.
Okay, sure.
Yay!
That's a snack.
Hi.
Hey.
I thought I'd check in. I know it's none of my business. I just want to make sure that you're okay.
Yeah, come in.
Okay.
No, I'm completely fine. I mean, on the one hand, Austin is saying things to me that I've wanted to hear for God knows how long. And on the other hand, he's the actual king of manipulation.
Hey, can I come in for a second?
Yeah.
Hey, did not know you were in here.
I hope this isn't out of line, but you look really nice, by the way.
You do. Yeah.
Thanks.
Just really worried about the girls. You know, I have experience with guys like this, and their dad just shows up out of nowhere, and he's acting like he's, you know, bother of the year when we know he isn't. And then what's going to happen? He's going to move back to New York, and then what? What happens to... Is it...
Alice, I've got to talk to you.
Can it wait? I'm a little bit busy.
No, it can't. I feel like everything is out of sorts between us, and wow, you look great and smell great. Can I come in?
Do you have an Advil?
I didn't realize I had an audience.
You guys, we're just going to have to talk about this later.
What, I didn't make the cut for the pre-party?
No, there is nothing going on. There's never been so many people in this room. We're going to be late. You guys, I will talk to you later. It's going to be good. Bye. Good night. Okay.
Night, kids.
I don't like them. It's way past Rosie's bedtime. Should we call and make sure that everything's okay?
You know, I'm kind of shocked she married that guy. I know she knows his bracelets are a problem.
I don't know. I mean, I could see them having a certain appeal when they were younger. The accent's cool.
Hey, we were just starting to, Oh, sorry.
Did you guys have a good night?
Yeah, nothing special. Just ate some lasagna. What was left of it?
How was your dinner?
The girls had a great time.
And you?
I actually had fun, too.
Well, we were going to have a nightcap. You want to come over to our place?
I'm exhausted. I'm going to hit the hay. Night, guys.
Yeah, good night. Night. It's not true. She never falls asleep before midnight.
Okay, thank you. We did not need to know that.
Night, night. I'll see you in the morning.
I love you, Daddy.
Oh, I love you too, my beautiful girl.
Reaches for the painting, floats in slow motion through the air.
Georgie,
hey.
Great news. The finance guy is flying in to meet with us next Friday. We're meeting him at Sunset Tower, and then we'll go from there to see Isabel's show.
Perfect. Hey, actually, hold on a sec.
Relax. I just want to show you an article I read about this guy. The painting floats in slow motion. What is this? What are you working on?
I was
writing something else?
Let me explain. Yes.
How could you do that? How could you do... We're almost done with our script. You're working on something else at the same time?
Okay, yes, but look, you've decided, right, that we're two halves of this whole, and I've been thinking that maybe I could be a whole on my own at some point, and our agents agree.
Okay, right. Okay, so you're the talent. I'm just the one who got us our financing, who directed our movie, who... submitted us to the festival, who got us to L.A.
You know that's not what I'm saying.
And then you go rogue, and you get another job without telling me. Shit, George.
You know, this has not stopped me from working on our movie. Not even one bit. And excuse me if I want to make some goddamn money and get the hell out of the mess that you've created in this house, by the way. Oh, did you not even realize? You don't even know? Did you think you could just have sex with her and play with her kids and everything would turn out fine? You know what? Leave your brain to science, Harry, because it's truly one in a mill.
You know what? No, I'm not letting you do this. I'm not, man. You're a little in love with Alice, and you're mad at me because of it.
Wow.
You and I have been down this road before.
Okay, I am not in love with her, okay? I just love a lot of things about her, like her face and her personality.
Hey. Look, guys. What is that?
Thank you.
Can I join you? Everything cool, brother?
I saw Harry take off. Seemed pretty heated.
I'm sorry, but I don't want to get into it. It's all good. You don't have to worry about it.
Well, I wouldn't say that. This is my house. My kids, my wife. If there's a problem, I think I have a right to know about it.
With all due respect, Austin, I don't know if Alice would call this your house, and she definitely wouldn't call herself your wife.
They are my kids, though, right? Mm. Is that one okay with you?
What exactly is it that you're doing here?
Yeah, it's a complicated situation at your age. I couldn't have understood it either.
Try me.
Well, sometimes you need a bit of space from the things you love in order for you to realize just how much you really need them.
Seriously? That sort of thing just does not apply to your wife and kids.
What do you want from me, man? I mean, you're gonna hate me, regardless of what I say. But if Alice and I are gonna try and work through our problems, which I think it's pretty clear we are, then this game of house you're all playing, it's gonna have to end.
And you think that's what Alice wants?
Alice doesn't know what she wants.
Alan, what's that for?
It was for Alan.
You know, you do not want to do this. I'm a trained athlete. I can box.
Okay, all right. I'm sorry.
You want to go fit, huh? You want to go? Come on, let's go.
Okay.
Let's go.
Hey.
Go. Hey. Did you stupid hipster brother sleep with my wife? Huh? Come on, man up and tell me. Tell me.
You know what? We're better off without you.
We? What are you even saying?
For a second.
He's a liability, okay? There are kids in this house.
Come on, Alice. This is insane.
This is too much for me. I didn't sign up for this. All of this.
I agree. I think he needs to leave.
I think you guys need to find somewhere else to stay while we get our lives back on track.
Wait. Alice.
I'm sorry, guys.
Thing, Al.
He did quite a number on you.
Ta-da. Alice, look at me for a second. Oh, God, I've missed you so much. I had no idea how to be alone.
Austin, what are we doing?
Our relationship is totally blurry, you know that.
I know it is. And once and for all, I think we need to clear it up.
I think we should
get back. I want a divorce.
I'm not following.
I want a divorce. Like, I legally don't want to be married.
No, I know what divorce means. I thought we weren't ready to make such a... So I'm the idiot who's dealt a winning hand and still managed to lose.
I think maybe this all worked out the way it was supposed to.
I guess we both know that if I'd seen a sliver of hope, I would have tried to weasel my way back in.
kind of kicked us out.
Seriously?
Yeah.
And what about Austin? He stayed?
Yeah. Oh.
You guys hungry? Just some leftover Nova.
Harry, we came here to apologize. Neither of us should have hidden anything from you.
Is that a no to the Nobu?
Awesome. What's Nobu? It's just sushi.
Okay, we were just afraid that you were going to think that we were doubting you or losing faith in the movie.
That's exactly what I think.
We're not bailing, man. My other job is basically done, and if Teddy lands another part, then we will work around it.
He's right. We're doing this.
All right, we're making this happen.
Oh, the Nobu.
Is Dad okay?
Yeah. Daddy is fine. He just has a little bruise, and he's asleep now, so he's gonna be okay. I'm really sorry that you guys had to see that.
Is he moving in with us?
Well, he's gonna live in LA, which is great, but he's not gonna live with us.
What about the guys? Did they leave? For good?
I think so.
Does that mean we won't ever see them again? I mean, George was going to come to my play.
Yeah, yeah, I know George, honey, and trust me, he will be there. Well, I don't know about you guys, but I'm kind of looking forward to it just being the three of us again.
Actually, I think that sounds good. I could use some peace and quiet.
We're still in the moving in phase.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
This place is great.
Uh-huh. Oh, man.
Are the guys here?
No, they just went out for a bit. They'll be back any minute. Look, this should be me showing up at your door, but I don't know, with Austin there,
he's gone.
He went back to New York?
No, he's here in L.A. Just not with me. We are officially done. So.
Wow. Wow, well, A-plus decision.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Alice, I should have said this before, in a realer way at least, but I'm sorry. I'm sorry for standing you up that night, and, I think, like, I've relived it, like, 1,000 times in my head, and I can't wrap my mind around what kind of a person would do that to you. Let alone, it was me. It was one of the top 5 worst decisions I've ever made. And I have made some pretty questionable decisions in my time. Look, bottom line, you deserve much, much better than me. I don't mean that like most guys mean it, which is that they don't mean it at all. I actually do. I really do.
You know, before I met you, I was probably more alone and terrified than I'd ever been in my entire life. And
plates up for ours.
Let me help you.
Yeah, thank you.
Hey, where's the kitchen?
It's over here. How's Iz? We've been texting
good.
A bit.
Yeah, she told me.
She's so hyped up for tomorrow.
Did she tell you she started meditating?
No, but
yeah.
I love that.
Oh, let me put those in a vase for you. Do you have a vase?
Okay.
Something to buy you as a housewarming gift.
All right. My guys.
Justin,
my guys. Listen, before we go in there, whatever happens, we're still going to make a great movie together. Okay? Not something you watch on your smartphone and forget about before it's even over. So we got the brains, we got the heart, we got the nerve.
Yeah?
All right, come on. All right, it's gonna be good.
Yeah,
it's gonna be good. Yeah, I know you come around on me.
Hey.
Yeah, we're here. Sure, yeah, no problem. It's running a bit late. All right. Showtime.
Okay, fellas, here's the thing. I love your script. I totally get what you're going for. But maybe we could make it even bigger.
Okay, sure, how so?
Maybe, I don't know, it could be sexier. You know, add some more excitement, more action. Maybe the Sam character has to assemble a group of guys from various locations, and then they have to pull off a big heist.
So basically Ocean's 11.
Yes, love it. Great. Young Oceans, exactly.
Sam isn't really big time like that. He's just doing it to get by, you know.
Right, right. I know, I thought that's why we could dial that up. And then we get somebody really great to play Sam, like that kid from Hunger Games.
Well, actually, we got Teddy attached. Remember, I told you about that?
Oh.
He's fantastic.
Right, yeah. You're Teddy.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we definitely find something for you to play. Look, Justin, I trust you. You know that.
Yeah.
And I think that you guys are super talented. My only concern is that it's too small. Or, I don't know, cute? Is that the right word?
No. We gotta run.
Wait, guys.
We appreciate you taking the time. We really, really do. But truthfully, we have an 11-year-old's play to attend. So if your answer is no, which it seems to be, since you've missed pretty much every lovely detail in the script, well, this isn't really gonna make much of a difference. But I'm gonna say it anyway. I think you're making a mistake. Teddy is one of the most talented actors of our generation. And George, he understands people, the way we think and why we do the unexplainable things we do. Film is the great love of our lives, and if you take a chance on us, there is like an 80% chance that we will not let you down. Now, Warren, quick question. You happen to have a car downstairs?
You were amazing! Amazing!
Aaron!
You sure you're okay with this?
Yes, there will be another guy. Do I look worried?
Once the show begins, no one is admitted. Those are the rules.
You're joking, right? It's a fifth grade play, not Hamilton.
I am under strict orders to close the doors at 6, and it is now 6:15, so...
I actually need to get backstage. There's a very, very special kid who will be totally
You know what? This is not my problem, bro.
Whoa! Sorry, bud!
Oh. Maybe he should be an action star.
Go.
Isabel Bloom.
What began? Sorry.
Come on. Are you George?
Yes.
Thank God.
Wait, who are you?
I'm Miss Avery.
You're Miss Avery?
Yeah. You're George?
Yeah.
Come on. She can see you from here.
What began?
Isabel. Isabel!
Because it definitely was.
Definitely.
It was a smash.
You got a standing O. There were moms in the audience who were crying.
Moms were crying. I was sobbing.
And that line about being a kid and growing up in New York, I mean, come on.
Oh, her bedtime was 8:30 in the city that never sleeps.
That's the one.
I like the kid who played Dad. What? Was it not about us? It was about us, right?
You're like a theater detective.